Hello everyone,
welcome back to SFDC Panther. This is Amit and in this video we are going to talk about how we can set up web2ks inside our Salesforce environment. The previous video that we have talked about is email2ks, and this is about web2ks where we can take the cases from the website. So you might have seen that whenever you are visiting a website, in the contact us section they are asking you to fill up information about you, like your email, your name, what is the issue you are facing, and what is the description, and then send it. So how we can do that inside our Salesforce environment, that's what we are going to see over here. Before we go ahead, please do like, share, subscribe the channel if you have not already done it, and also press the bell icon. Now let's quickly start. We are here inside our Salesforce environment. What we need to do is, you just need to search for web2ks, or if you type web in the email, not email, in the quick search box, you will see under services you are saying web2ks. So the very first step is to enable that. Enable, what you need to do is just click on this web2ks, and you will see there is a checkbox called web2ks checkbox. You can also have required capture if you want. What is going to be the default case origin is always going to be the web, because we are receiving the cases from the website. Then what is default response template? For now, let it be. We are not going to do anything. If you have some sort of email signature for your company, like thanks and record, service support team, SFDC Panther kind of thing, you can also have. Go ahead and click on save. This auto response email settings we will talk about later on. Once you have saved this, again type web in the quick search box, and this time select web2ks HTML generator. This page is going to let you to select the case fields that you wanted to have inside your website basically, and the different fields like company name, basically contact name. This is going to be your name, then email, then phone, subject, description. So this is basically, these are the basically few things. If you want to have a case reason why you wanted to create a case, you can also have. Then it is saying that include recapture. We are going to say this time we are not going to use recapture. Then visible in self-service portal, yes, so that we can have in our digital experiences or our site.com, where the user will be redirected once their case has been created into Salesforce. So for that, for now, what we can do is we can use any dummy URL. I'm going to use the URL for my web. Go ahead and click on generate. Once you have generated, you just need to copy this code, paste it somewhere in your HTML editor like Notepad++, and we are going to test this so that once we are done with the testing, we can basically send this to the client and we can ask them to use that inside the website where they want it to put. And there are a few things. Basically, this is the servlet which is going to do the trick for creating a case, where it is going to create a case. This is the org ID of your Salesforce environment, where the case is going to be created, and where the user is going to be redirected. Then these are all the fields like contact name, then you have email, case reason, and these are things are here. Then there is a button called submit. Want to change the name, if you want to change the label, you can also have. Now if you see here for case reason, as this is a pick list field, you are able to see all the pick list values over here as well. So now as we have got the HTML file, we'll save it, we'll test it, and once it is done, we can send it to the business. So this is the name of my file, which is web2ks. Okay, I'm going to store inside desktop. And then I have got this hypertext markup language, which is HTML. Go ahead and save it. Now once we have got, we'll get back to the basically desktop and we will say web2ks. And this is how our form, this is basically, which is not beautiful, not formatted, nothing like that. This is, if you want, you can have to put some sort of cascade style seed like CSS and all using Bootstrap or some other CSS file, and then you can do that. So let's quickly say here, I'll say that Amit Singh, email, I can have my own email. Case region, let's say that installation. Phone number, I can have some dummy number. Subject is, I will say that test web to case. Description is the same. Go ahead and click on submit. So once the case is created in the system, it is going to redirect you the redirect URL which we have used. You can also change that URL over here in the HTML, and this is the one. So now as we are here inside our redirect URI, basically most of the time it is the thank you page. You can use that. And if you get back to the case inside your Salesforce environment case tab, here we should be able to see a new case which has been created as a result of web to case, and which is here test web to case. If you open this, you will see that there is one mail which has been basically sent to the customer, which is the reply. We have talked about that default reply to case, a default email, that one. And if you see here, the status is new, test web to case, description is again, and case region is installation and origin is web. So that is how your web to case works, and you can quickly basically get the cases from your website inside Salesforce, where your your service representatives can work with them and help them to resolve the case. So this is it all about the web to case, how web to case works, how you can set up. And there was one thing which we are talking about reCAPTCHA. So you can also, if you want to use a Google reCAPTCHA, you can also use that one. So this is it for this video. Thank you for your time. And in the coming video, we are going to talk about case response rule. So we'll meet you into the next video. Thank you.